So now let us define the derivative of a function. So derivative, whenever we say derivative, it means that rate of change of a variable with respect to another variable. Okay. So the derivative of a function f of x at x is equal to a is given by f dash of a, which is nothing but limit h tending to 0 f of a plus h minus f of a divided by h. So this is for a specific number x is equal to a. In case for a general x, you can write it as f dash of x is equal to limit h tending to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So this is how we will be writing it for any general x. And if f is differentiable at a, then obviously f is continuous at a, but the converse is not true. Okay, so let us start with the problem. Let us find the domain at which the function f of x is equal to mod x is continuous and differentiable. Already we have discussed about mod x, that is limit x tending to 0, mod x equal to 0. This we have already done in topic 2. So anyway, we will recollect the same again and then we will go on to the differentiability concept also. So now let us consider the function mod x. Whenever I say mod x, it is nothing but plus x for x greater than or equal to 0 and minus x for x less than 0. And so you will be remembering all these things. So I will write it directly. So limit x approaches 0 from left mod x is nothing but is equivalent to limit x approaches 0 from right mod x is equivalent to 0. This we have already done. Okay. And at x is equal to 0, it means that the function is continuous, since both left hand limit and right hand limit are equal and the function is defined. We say that the function f of x is equal to mod x is continuous. Therefore, we can write the domain of mod x as the domain of mod x is nothing but minus infinity comma plus infinity. Okay, so the continuity concept is over. Now let us go for the differentiability. So now let us check the differentiability. So here also the function has a breaking at x is equal to 0. Okay, so based on the definition of mod x, so now let us consider for x greater than 0. So for x greater than 0, by the definition of differentiability, that is the derivative, f dash of x is nothing but limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, right? And here for x greater than 0, mod x is defined as plus x. So this is equivalent to limit h tends to 0 f of x is nothing but x here. Therefore, f of x plus h is x plus h minus x divided by h. Here x will get cancelled and you will be getting the value as h by h also will get cancelled and you will get the value as 1. Therefore, since the limit exists, f dash of x is differentiable for x greater than 0. Similarly, let us consider the other case for x less than 0, strictly less than 0. So what will happen? Here mod x is nothing but minus x. So now f dash of x will be equivalent to, here f of x is nothing but minus x, therefore it is minus of, according to the definition, it is limit h tends to 0, this minus of x plus h minus of minus x divided by h. So this is equivalent to minus x plus plus into minus is again minus. So here it is minus h, and here minus into minus is plus x divided by h, and here it is limit h tends to 0. So x will get cancelled and here minus h by h will give you the value as minus 1. Okay, again the function is defined. Okay, therefore the differentiability exists. Therefore f dash of x is differentiable. Okay, let me write here f dash of x is differentiable for x greater than 0. Now we have to discuss at the point x is equal to 0, for x is equal to 0. So for x is equal to 0, f dash of x is nothing but limit h tends to 0, here this is f of 0 plus h minus f of 0 divided by h, and here this is equivalent to limit h tends to 0, here it is modulus h minus 0 divided by h. Because f of 0, that is f of x is nothing but mod x, and here x is equal to 0 implies this is mod 0, so obviously this is going to be 0. Therefore, this is equivalent to mod h by h. Now, let us discuss limit h tends to 0 from left mod h by h. So, when you approach from the left side, this is going to be minus h by h. So, this is going to give you the value as minus 1. Similarly, when you approach from right side, this is going to be mod h by h will give you plus h by h. So, this will give you the value as plus 1. Here, left hand limit is not equivalent to right hand limit. Therefore, at x is equal to 0, it is not differentiable. The function is not differentiable. So, we can conclude that the domain right here, therefore, the function is differentiable for x greater than 0, and it is differentiable for x less than 0, and it is not differentiable for x is equal to 0. Therefore, the domain of differentiability is nothing but minus infinity to 0 union 0 to infinity. Okay, so this is how we are supposed to find the domain for this. Okay, now let us move on to the next session, that is derivatives of logarithmic and exponential function. So here f of x, so I have listed out some few formulas, that is f of x is a power x, then f dash of x is nothing but a power x ln a. If it is an exponential, then the differentiation of an exponential term is exponential itself. Then differentiation of ln x is 1 by x, and differentiation of log base a x is 1 by x ln a. Okay, so let us start with the problem. Let us find what is dou f by dou x. Given function f of x is nothing but 2 ln x plus 10 e power 2 x plus log x plus 5 plus 3 x power 4. So, when you differentiate this with respect to x, you will be getting df by dx is equal to 2 times. What is the formula for ln x? Differentiation of ln x is nothing but 1 by x. So, for this part it is 1 by x. Then plus 10 times, 10 is a constant. So, whenever a function is multiplied by a constant, you can retain the constant as it is. And the differentiation for e power 2 x is e power 2 x into 2. Okay, whatever the coefficient that comes along with x, that has to be written here. So, it is e power 2 x into 2 plus, and the differentiation of log x is 1 by x, and here differentiation of a constant term which is being separately written. So, for a constant term it is going to be 0, and for 3 x power 4, 3 will remain as it is. For x power n, okay, let me write here, differentiation of x power n is nothing but n x n minus 1. Therefore, it will be 4 x power 4 minus 1 is 3. Therefore, when you simplify this, this will be equivalent to, so this will be 2 by x plus 20 e power 2 x plus 1 by x plus 12 x power 3. So, this is a simple differentiation of a simple function. Now, we will move on to the next rule, that is the product rule. Whenever a function has a product of two functions, then f dash of x is given by u v dash plus v u dash. So, here v prime or v dash, you can call it anyway. This v prime stands for differentiation with respect to x, and here u prime is differentiation of u with respect to x. So, another format is given here, it is u of x differentiation of v plus v of x differentiation of u. It means that whenever they are given a product of two functions, keep one function as a constant and differentiate the another term, then plus keep the another function as a constant and differentiate the next term. So, now let us see this problem. Here f of x is equal to x square plus 2x minus 1 into x power 10. So, let us call the first function as u and the second function as v. So, u is equal to x square plus 2x minus 1, and here v is equal to x power 10. Let us differentiate this. Let me denote this by u prime. When you differentiate this with respect to x, it will be 2x plus 2, and the constant will become 0. And v prime will be equivalent to 10 x power 9. So, using the formula differentiation of x power n. Okay. So, already we have shown that differentiation of x power n is nothing but n x n minus 1. Okay. So, now, so u prime is this and v prime is this. So, by the formula, differentiation of u v is nothing but u v dash plus v u dash. So, this is equivalent to u into v dash. So, this is 10, let me write the constant in the front. So, this is 10 times x square plus 2x minus 1 into x power 9. And then plus v times, that is x power 10 into u prime, that is 2x plus 2. So this will be the answer for this problem. Okay. Next, we will move on to the next rule, that is quotient rule or division rule. That is differentiation of u divided by v is nothing but v u dash minus u v dash divided by v square. So numerator is nothing but u and denominator is nothing but v. So for this problem, u is nothing but 3x square minus 5 and v is nothing but root x. So what is u prime here? U prime is, when you differentiate this term, this will be 6x. And v prime, which is nothing but x power 1 by 2. So this is equivalent to x power half. When you differentiate this term, this will give you 1 by 2. Let me write here 1 by 2 x power 1 by 2 minus 1. So this will be equivalent to 1 by 2 root x. Because this is going to give you minus half, you can bring it to the denominator. So this will be 1 by 2 root x. So v prime is nothing but 1 by 2 root x. So now apply in the formula. The differentiation of u by v is nothing but v du minus u dv divided by v square, or this is nothing but u prime and this is nothing but v prime. Okay, so this is equivalent to v is nothing but root x into u prime, that is 6x, minus u is nothing but 3x square minus 5, and v prime is nothing but 1 by 2 root x fully divided by v square. V is nothing but root x. When you square root x, this is going to give you, sorry, x. So let me write here. So this is equivalent to 6x root x minus 3x square minus 5 into 1 by 2 root x divided by x. So if you take the LCM in the numerator, if you take the LCM, root x into root x will give you x. Therefore, already you have x term. So this will become 6x square minus 3x square. I am just taking the minus sign inside. So this will be plus 5 fully divided by 2x root x. So when you simplify, this is going to give you 3x square plus 5 divided by 2x root x. Okay. So this is the answer for the division rule. Right. Now we will move on to the next topic, that is chain rule. The chain rule is given by dy by dx is equal to dy by du into du by dx. That is, you will be getting an intermediate variable u. For example, see the first problem. Here, y is equal to u power 10. They have specified separately. And u is equal to 1 minus x power 5 is being given separately. Therefore, but here you can observe that y is a function of u. And u is a function of x. And we are supposed to find dy by dx. Therefore, dy by dx with the intermediate variable u. So, how do you write that as? It is being written as dy with respect to u only will be knowing, right? So, dy by du into du. U in terms of x you will be knowing. Therefore, it is du divided by dx. Therefore, y is equal to u power 10. Therefore, dy by du when I differentiate, will be getting it as 10 into u power 9. Similarly, you know u is equal to 1 minus x power 5 and du is nothing but minus 5 x to the power 4. Okay. So, we are going to substitute here for getting the value of dy by dx. So, this will be equivalent to 10 u power 9 into minus 5 x power 4. So, but everything has to be written in terms of x. Therefore, you are going to replace. So, let us multiply these two constants. So, this will be minus 50. U is nothing but 1 minus x power 5 the whole to the power 9 into x power 4. So, this will be the answer for the first substitution. When we come to the second substitution, u is not being specified separately, but we can rewrite that as here f of x is equal to root of x square plus 1 is there. Let us call this as some other function c u. Okay. Therefore, f of x is nothing but root u. Okay. So, this is nothing but y. So, y is a function of u and u is nothing but a function of x. So, again you can apply the same concept as we did here and apply the chain rule and you can easily get the answer. You can try this as a homework for you. Okay. Thank you for this. So we will stop with this. We will move on to the next topic. So in this topic we have seen the derivative differentiation rule, then where the function mod x is differentiable, those things we have learnt, and along with that we have learnt the product rule, then the division rule, that is quotient rule, then we have learnt the chain rule also. Okay, so we will stop with this, right? Thank you.